check out Resident Evil Code Veronica Eck. This game is so sick. This is probably my favorite Resident Evil. Which might be hard for some people to believe, because a lot of people hate on this game now. But when it came out, it was the shit. This was like the best Resident Evil. I don't know what it is, why I like it so much. Probably because it was on the Dreamcast. I had to get a Dreamcast just to play this game. And up to that point, I had played Resident Evil 2 was my first one on 64. And then they ported 2 and 3 to Dreamcast like a few months before this came out. And so I was able to play 3 for the first time. And the thing that was cool on that was they had these like little epilogue chapters. And the one for Jill talked about how like she was trying to go find Chris and he was off to Paris to find Claire or whatever. She'd gotten fucking arrested for shoplifting or whatever. So that was cool. And I was like fully immersed in the lore at the time. So I was really anticipating this game. And I remember, like, it's crazy the graphics jump from. A lot of people probably think this game looks shitty now, but the jump from the first three games to this was pretty huge. This was actually supposed to be Resident Evil 3, but Sony threw some cash-ish Capcom's way to keep all the numbered titles on PlayStation. The last time they do shit like that. But yeah, this game's tight. I really like it a lot. So the last time I played this game was when they did the HD re-release. It goes back in like 2011. And that was the first time I'd actually played this version, the Eck version, which has like something like 10 minutes of extra footage, which is kind of weird. I always wondered, like, did they keep that shit out on purpose, like for Sony or what? Was it gonna be early DLC since the Dreamcast was online? But yeah, I remember thinking it was really cool. All right, let's go ahead and check it out. This is gonna be sick.
Resident Evil.
Love this game.
The American Midwestern town, Raccoon City, has been completely decimated due to the T-virus outbreak that was instigated by the International Corporation.
This is how Resident Evil Zero starts too.
Claire Redfield, who arrived in Raccoon City to search for her lost brother Chris,
I don't think
and
it's
a
the same
rookie police
voice, but it's
officer,
like
Leon S.
the same
Kennedy,
area.
managed to escape from the city. But their ordeal was only a prelude to things to come. Three months later.
This opening cutscene is so sick.
Identification
She's
number
actually
is
really cute in this game. She's
WKD4496.
got the choker.
Welcome to your new home.
She's got the big ass mom
Her
jeans.
name is Claire Redfield. We caught her trespassing in our
Everything
Paris
in
lab
game
facility
looks really
10
good.
days ago. She
The
apparently
cutscenes are a little.
infiltrated the complex looking for her lost brother, Chris Redfield, one of the surviving members of RPD's famous STARS
There's a compression
teams.
on that shit. this looks like it's running on Sega Genesis. After I go to Taco Bell. See if they use this to put it in the file thing. Alright, we already know that. We're resident experts. So this is a new mechanic. You can actually equip the lighter and walk around. Kind of serves a function later. Allows you to traverse some areas safely, whereas otherwise you couldn't. Also, the knife has if you hit a zombie in the kneecaps at the right moment, they'll their knees will buckle. And you can shank them on.
Go on, get out of here.
So the knife's
this
not
place
worthless.
Is finished. I don't know. It might have been a special forces team.
I never really
but in any case, this prison's been taken over. Troops have been wiped out.
What are you saying?
You're free to leave the complex.
Yeah, the characters look a little
but
blocky.
You may as
the
well know you have no chance of getting off this island.
I have that flat texture.
And what about you? What are you going to do?
Don't worry about me.
Not worried about your ass. But here, in game, I think Claire looks really clear. She was the first love, Resident Evil 2. Pick this shit up. We're gonna have to help this guy out later. Hemostatic medicine. Grab the new life. Musical. forget about this stuff. Also in Resident Evil 2, they have a thing where, like, you can see zombies when you open the door. And then they'll be, like, right in your face when the room loads. I kind of miss that old shit. They kind of do it in 7, just without the load screen part. Since it's in first person, you get, like, the same feeling.
Misunderstanding, but I thought you were another one of those monsters.
Shut up! Make one wrong move and I'll shoot.
That's beautiful. I said I was sorry. My name's Steve.
A sword.
I was a prisoner on this island. And I'm guessing you're not from Umbrella either.
No, I'm Claire. Claire Redfield.
Claire?
Respect the name.
Nice. I'll remember that. Hey,
family.
There's an airport around here. And once I find it, I can finally escape from this crazy island. I'll see ya.
Hey, wait up!
I don't want you following me, lady.
You're
only slowing me down.
Fuck you. might try to knife kneecap one of these guys, see if I get the timing. Oh, shit. Ah, oh, wrong button. Yeah, I'm a little rusty. I've been out of practice wrestling for a while. Oh shit. Oh, you motherfucker. Damn, he seems like he got me from really far away. Satisfying. beat the game, you get these little extra modes where you kind of run through a level. Kind of like Force Survivor in Resident Evil 2. And one of them, you get to play as Wesker, and he only has the Noid. I never really tried it, but I think I'm going to try it after I beat this. I've also done where if you beat the game in under 4 hours without saving, I think those are the only requirements, you can get the rocket launcher. Rocket launcher. And I did that before. Back in the old days when I had time for this shit. Hey, there's an herb in that room.
Please deposit any metallic items you have in the security box.
I'm about to have this fucked up if there's no way to check on shit. They did this in Resident Evil 7 too. I wonder if this is the first time I think you had to do that in Resident Evil 2.
Chris Redfield.
Looking at porn, huh? Chris Redfield, gay porn.
What are you doing here?
Chris Redfield. Is he a relative of yours or something?
You mean my brother?
Ah, your siblings.
That's what that means.
Well, it seems your brother is under surveillance by Umbrella.
What?
What?
I've got to contact Leon and tell him to let my brother know he's being monitored.
Leon.
It's a good thing I have access to an outside connection from here.
She mentioned Leon.
Well, that file shows the latitude and longitude of this place. Why don't you send your brother the coordinates and ask him to come help?
Thanks. I'll do that.
He's going to Spain.
Hey, I was just kidding. There's no way he could get here, even if he is your brother.
Yes, he can. I'm sure of it.
No way. He won't come. You'll just end up disappointed if you rely on others.
Like
believe me, okay. I know.
Oh, it's got issues.
What was that all about?
What's up his butt? A lot of people don't like the melodrama in this game. They say it's too anime. But, I kind of look at the Resident Evil games as, like, they're all homages to horror and, like, different horror genres. So, like, this one's more of the psychological thriller. Kind of like an homage to Psycho. It's kind of elements of the thing too in the Antarctica area. As far as the setting goes anyway. Sure. It's like an old school habit.
Deposit any metallic items you have in the security box.
I can't do this yet. I need the film or whatever. I wonder if I can put it in here.
Yeah.
Life is so much fun, man. I guess I can use one. Fine. Padlock. It's for back here, I think.
Yeah.
Please deposit any metallic items you have in the security box.
Shut up, bitch. On the drill. Oh, fuck. Damn, they got crazy reach. How am I doing health-wise? Yeah, Claire's a hardy girl, man. She can take it. Zooms in on that one part. Oh fuck, I forgot about the dogs. Flies or whatever there are sound crazy.
Bye.
Keep the knife. Not a fancy bullet. Yeah.